that good. In fact, we have Gaurang Shah joining us to do some analysis of the numbers that have gone by, that have come in for Maruti Suzuki. Gaurang, clear miss for Maruti. We were expecting a very strong quarter, but clearly it has disappointed. What's your own sense about the numbers?
I think disappointment definitely there, but one has to also factor in that they had seen launches in form of S-Cross and Baleno. And my sense is that coming next month, you will also see an SUV by the name Breeza coming to the market. So you, and of course, they had exclusive sales store in form of Nexa being set up. So because of all these and because of the new launches, you definitely would have the higher advertisement and marketing and sales promo expense. This could be one of the reasons why, again, you've seen a slight bit of miss on Maruti. But if I look at the last 3 months, month-on-month sales number, then they were looking very encouraging. And in fact, the demand for Baleno has gone up significantly. And there is also a demand for S-Cross, which was otherwise a very lackluster kind of environment. So my sense is that coming quarters to come by, and of course, the report from SIAM, you should see better numbers from Maruti. But let me give a disclosure. We do have a positive coverage on Maruti.
Gaurang, this is Hiral on this side. Now, as we've seen in terms of our margins are concerned, we have seen a miss on that number that has come in at 14.4% for our viewers versus an estimate of 16.14. The raw material cost as a percentage of the net sales, that is lower in this quarter. However, it's the yen appreciation that has, you know, that's the major reason why we are seeing this kind of hit in terms of our margins are concerned. So do you, are you expecting this kind of a trend to continue where margins are concerned, or will this be a one-off case as of now?
Well, one thing I can say over here is that operation efficiency should bring in positivities. What we don't know of is the currency market and the way the movement will happen with yen, rupee, and of course, the biggest currency being the dollar. So in the currency market, it's going to be a difficult call to take because I really don't have any view on that. But my sense is in terms of other misses, if you improve the operation efficiency, you can definitely make up for the lost margins. Currency uncertainty is an uncharted territory on which I could not comment.
Okay.
Gaurang, you know, you spoke about the new launches, and that is something that has worked for Maruti in the last year. They were one of the more successful manufacturers with really good response they saw on most of their products, of course, barring S-Cross, as you pointed out. And the way, you know, some of their models, we've seen some discounting that they had to do to push sales. Is that a concern?
I don't think it's a major concern because it was only an S-Cross that initial we saw, you know, heavy discounts being offered. But if I look at the Baleno, I think there is already a waiting period, and correct me if I'm wrong, on the booking. And the new launch Breeza is going to be something that the market has much awaited. And going further, what I also understand is that they are going to launch a compact SUV, which already they have showcased in terms of their prototype model. So you have these kind of launches coming through, and a very, you know, robust export market along with their entry level segment car demand going up from semi urban and rural area. My sense is that you could possibly see the improvement in numbers for quarters to come by for Maruti.
All right. Also, Gaurang, very quickly want to get your comments on the way the government is pushing this whole green technology, hybrid, electric. Maruti clearly has no product immediately in its portfolio, and they haven't really talked about it. Is that something where you see company fall behind the competitors, or you think they can pull up something from their global you know, portfolio and bring it for the Indian markets? How quickly will they be able to adapt to the change that perhaps could come in?
Well, I think they are well capable of, and they have got their partner Suzuki to provide them with any assistance in terms of newer technologies and green fuel is concerned. And if I'm not mistaken, they have a hybrid in Ciaz, which was replaced by S-Cross, I beg your pardon, SX4, if I'm not mistaken. And over there, they have launched one hybrid model. But of course, acceptance is going to take a while for such newer technologies to be, you know, marketed on a larger scale. And as the environment depends, I think all, not only Maruti, all automobile manufacturing companies, including two-wheelers going forward, will have to spend on R&D and come out with much environment-friendly technology and fuels and emission norms should go down. So yes, you have to be prepared for the future.
Right. And how do you see the domestic story with many competitors? Maruti, of course, retains its leadership position as a big gap between the first and the second player. You think they'll be able to retain that over a period of time and the 47% odd market share that they have?
Well, given the kind of dominance that it has seen, despite the very competitive launches at a very efficient price tag or economical price tag, they have been maintaining their run rate. And my sense is that if you are a Maruti, car owner, then you will find it very difficult to migrate, because I also happen to be a Maruti car owner, and I find it extremely affordable and economical in terms of maintenance, etc. So this dominance will stay. But I think it is going to be prudent on the management part to invest more in R&D and make their presence felt in verticals which we have drawn up. Like, for example, the compact SUV and SUV, that market has already been taken over by Dusters and the Cruze and the Sierras of the world. I beg your pardon. There has been a lot of launches in this particular segment, and Maruti has actually missed out on the compact SUV and SUV segment. And of course, their erstwhile Kajashi, which was a high-end sedan, did not really take off. So if they can make the presence felt over there, I think they can definitely maintain their market share and even improve it going forward.
All right, Gaurang, thank you so much for your thoughts and analysis on the numbers. Well, Maruti clearly missing the estimates on the profit front. Margins also have been lower than what we were expecting. Obviously, the currency impact and lower realizations possibly are the reasons why the company has not seen as great a quarter as it had.